just a nobody, we're trying to tell everybody all about somebody who saved my soul. Hi, I'm Angela Berg. You know, I think we all can kind of connect with Mary's story. You know, have you ever had a plan and all of a sudden your plans unravel, and then all of a sudden you found out this plan you had unraveled and there is a big reward? So some of these people here in the congregation tonight, I'm sure you're seniors. So let's go back to being a senior in high school. Do you remember the most common question everybody would ever ask you? What are you going to do for the rest of your life? What do you say? And that's really, honestly, kind of a hard question, because this day and age, we just so want to be in control and we have everything all planned out, right? Well, take a look at Mary's story. Look at where she's at. She's going to get married to Joseph, the descendant of King David. She's probably got the wedding already planned, and her life is just going to work out. And all of a sudden, you know, if you ask me the same question, hey, what are you going to do when you're done with high school? Well, see, back then, I didn't even really know about Jesus. It wasn't until I met my husband and his family, his parents, and they showed me Jesus. So if you would have asked me, what are you going to do when you're done with high school? I was going to go to college, go and get a corporate job and climb up that corporate ladder and get married, have kids, and retire, right? So that was just like, that was my plan. Well, I did go to college. I did land this great job in sales. I worked for a $16 billion medical device company, and I traveled 4 states. And I would just travel, and every year I would hit my numbers. Just to give you an idea kind of the landscape of how my life was, I would leave every Monday, and I would not get home until Friday. And I did this year after year, and I'd start at 5 in the morning and then I'd go until 10, 11 o'clock at night. And you're like, what? You're working so much? Well, out in this congregation, you have grandkids and kids, and you're probably putting in the same kind of hours as that I was. So my perfect plan, I was just planning to retire. So if you go back to Mary's story, she had her whole life planned, and then all of a sudden an angel appeared and said that she's going to be conceived by the Holy Spirit and Jesus was going to be born. Can you imagine? Like, all of a sudden your whole life has been tipped upside down. Well, I can kind of connect with that, because again, I was working like crazy. I have to admit, I was a workaholic. I worked all the time. I worked for the same company for 24 years, and I was so successful at it. But meanwhile, my health was deteriorating. As you can see, I have bad rheumatoid arthritis, and each step hurts. So maybe I don't walk the fastest, and I was putting in all these crazy hours, and my company was, they were not able to find me a new position. So all of a sudden they fired me. Oh boy, talk about my plans being turned upside down like Mary's, right? Here I was going to retire, and I really honestly struggled. I mean, I really went to a dark place. I mean, like, that was my identity. I was like a hamster on a wheel, and I couldn't get off. I was working all these hours, and that's who everybody knew who I was, right? And I just felt like a failure. I felt like I was ashamed. felt a little humiliated. What was I going to do? So what I did is I decided to dig deeper in His Word and volunteer at the church, because guess what? I had to find a new normal. So have you ever been in one of those places that, you know, your normal has been tipped upside down? Maybe you lost somebody unexpectedly. Maybe you lost a job. Maybe your finances are not the best. Maybe the spouse that you thought you'd live happily ever after is no longer. And you feel alone. Well, guess what? I felt alone too. So I volunteered more, trying to find my new normal. And I remember somebody telling me, memorize some scripture. And so when I get scared, boy, there were a lot of days I was scared. Because financially, my identity, that's who I was. So when I was scared, so I'd memorize some scripture. So the scripture that I tended to actually memorize is, in God, I can do all things through God who strengthens me. And so when I get to that area and I'm really scared, that is what I say. So going to the big rewards, I think it's interesting. I ended up applying for different jobs, trying to find my new normal. And like with Mary, she is having the son. It's interesting. So all my life, I've done it my way. I have just done it my way. I had a conversation with Jesus and said, you need to lead me. I'm no longer going my way. So then I started incorporating Him into my conversations on, do I feel peace if I go to the right or to the left? I never knew that. I just kind of tended to do it my way. So there was a job that was opening up at the elementary school as a teacher's associate. So I applied and I went to this interview and I felt peace. Totally different from what I used to do. But I heard God say, you know what? You need to be there. And so I help three little boys in third grade that have trouble learning. And the peace and the joy that I get from them and the kids that come around to help them, my bucket is full. And what's so interesting is that I ask God every day, please let me be a bright light in somebody's life. And I'll have kids randomly come up and give me a hug. So one day, you know, had one of those crazy days, right? Wish everything was perfect, but it wasn't. So I had this crazy day. Had a little boy come up to me and say, Mrs. Berg, I've got something for you. I'm like, okay, what? He drew me this picture. And this picture says, be the change you wish to see. To me, that was a God wink that I'm at the right place for this time in my life. So, in conclusion, what I tend to do is that, you know what, this whole life with our internet and the cell phones and kids going this way and going to work and trying to get everything together, I know one thing about planning, and that is, it's not about me. It's not about we. It's about He and His plan for your life. There's a reason you're sitting in this pew tonight. So I thank you for coming together to know Jesus. Now go and serve and make a difference. God bless. I'm just a nobody, trying to tell everybody all about somebody who saved